Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillahirabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala asyrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi washabbihi ajmain. Alhamdulillah, we are still continuing with our growth model. I'm talking about how we are going to transform ourselves using positive habits. So GROWTH now on the H part. So we are providing you free life coach training program all over the world. If you are interested, just go to our website islamicpsychology.net and you can get your certification done quite easily by following my video and do some practicum. All right. So I have explained to you that we have this domain, the four chain of domain within ourselves in terms of our physical existence, the jasad, our akal, the mind, mental domain, then our heart, qalb, the heart, emotion domain, and then we have our roh, and these are like a chain together, which if it's in the balance, we having a nafs or a soul that is balanced and that can be infused with the nur from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right, this nur becomes what we say about iman, and this is where Islam ihsan becomes a full flowering of our life. So if we can understand these four domains, we'll be able to understand that there's a lot of scientific research now, okay? Because as I mentioned in the previous video, we must have physical wellness and physical hygiene, the habits and the goodness of having a good diet, a good lifestyle, exercise and so on. So that is just a physical aspect. But what about the mental, the akal, the positive thinking, the value system of being in tune with the greater good and so on. All right, then what about the emotions, the heart? All right, and then the roh. So I'm going to show you how there's a lot of research now done by a lot of universities, whether it is in MIT or University of California, or even for example institute like HeartMath Institute and many other universities working and trying to develop mindfulness. So they are talking about that the brain is just not the brain, but you have the mind, which is infused. That means the brain is just a receiver. The transmitter is the mind. You can go to the videos of Dan Siegel, where he has his idea of mindsight, which brings about the idea that there is a higher realm of existence for the mind, and there's a higher realm of existence for the heart. So this is all now being tabulated by a lot of universities, and inshallah, we Muslims must, our universities must also do this research, because our ibadah actually bring us closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we have this coherence in terms of our mind coherence and then heart coherence and spiritual coherence. So we have the physical wellness and hygiene coherence. So our P is coherent with our mind, coherent to our E, coherent to our spirit, and we have a wonderful life. So this is the beauty of Islam, and now science is already producing the result that shows that if you are just living in the physical domain, just sex, drug addiction, video addiction, all kind of addiction that is being dished out to you, private jet, even you, it's not going to give you happiness. A lot of rich people, they cannot sleep, even like Elon Musk, all right? The founder of Tesla, he can't sleep at night unless he has some drug to put him to sleep. So a simple gift of having peace and tranquility for sleep, they cannot even have it. Imagine. And you have billionaires jumping out of the building, killing themselves and so on, because they do not have the fundamental idea of the realm of existence, the four domains, which Al-Imam Ghazali have explained, that our nafs at a higher level is controlled by our roh, which is linked to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah shower His love, His mercy, His grace, His goodness to us all the time. It is showering through. All right, then it comes to our heart, and our heart comes to our akal, and comes to our physical body. And if they are integrated, as I've given you in my previous video, the FET cycle, feelings, emotion, thoughts, coming from the higher realm, and then linking to the thoughts, emotion and feelings, TF cycle at the physical body. So you have the FET cycle permeating your whole reality as a human being. The Caliph of Allah on this earth, the Abdul of Allah, working together with your physical body. So if you understand this, I have to repeat this many times, because this will be the basis of psychological balance, psychological happiness, fulfillment, sa'ada, and so on. Because if you don't understand this, then you are working on the materialistic psychology, which has not solved the problem of humanity. In fact, our psychological problem is getting beyond us. That's why now we are being dragged towards obedience, being dragged towards just having a balance in life. Other than that, you cannot have balance because of the severe addiction we have mentioned in the previous video. So we have to develop a healing technique, which I'll give you later on, much more. But what is important, for example, a lot of universities are looking at the heart intelligence, the CULP, all right, and how the HRV, heart rate variability incoherence. This is showing how, as your heart beat, and internally there is a coherence or no coherence, all right. This is the heart rate, and then the time per second, and then this is impaired performance in terms of your life. If the heart rate is HRV, the heart rate variability, is like this jagged, you are living in frustration, anxiety, worry, depression, irritation, sickness. So the whole HRV will also determine your physical wellness. But here you are talking about the domain of the mind and the domain of the heart linked together. Your heart is linked to your mind. Okay, this is where mindfulness come in. So you want to come in, you do, for example, for the non-Muslims, they have to think about their breathing, breathing from the heart, and then breathe out. But it's still empty. They have not put in. As we Muslims, we breathe in, we have the remembrance of Allah, our zikrullah, and so on, which I'm going to teach you. But still, just with breathing, and then hold, and then exhale, calm breathing, they find that actually you can create some sort of positive emotion. Appreciation, love, courage, happiness, fulfillment, and so on. So this is where your heart rate variability is coherence. So you have two states, and this is now proven in many, many researchers all over the world. That's why they say, okay, for you to have a normal, good human life, you must be meditating or having mindfulness at least 1 hour a day, or some of them even going to extreme 2 hours a day of meditation. We Muslims, we meditate 5 times a day. We have our Subuh prayer, or Zuhur prayer, or Asar prayer, or Maghrib prayer, or Ishaq prayer, and you combine together is about 1 hour, or maybe 30 minutes, so it depends how fast you say your prayer. But if you say your prayer with the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the proper niyat and intention, you get the full coherence of the love of Allah, because Allah shower His love. Because we are His Khalifa, our existence is based on knowing Him. And to know Him, you know His ultimate fullness of love to us. So we have this love, we have this coherence. Alright, so we have this coherence at the physical level, is manifested in our physical heart. It is manifested to our mind, our akal, al-kulli and al-kal al-juzi. It is manifested in our qalb, at the physical heart, where this heart rate variability is being measured, to the higher heart center, the qalb, linking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and our roh. So when you understand this basis of Islamic psychology, we have a very powerful methodology to resolve all psychological problems for the ummah. Only there are many variations of techniques and so on, but all this basically comes about of how we tune ourselves to the habits of integration, of integrative thoughts, mind, integrative heart, integrative role, that we become a wonderful human being, which I'm going to give you more and more ideas. So remember, habits, you're talking about good physical habit in terms of physical wellness and hygiene, good mind habits in terms of mind, positive mind habits and wellness, good heart, where we infuse with love, mercy, compassion, and so on, and the spirit. Because if you look at this heart rate variability, you can see this jagged is because of frustration, because of anxiety, because of depression, because of OCD and all kind of other things. Stress syndrome, post-traumatic stress syndrome, and so on. But with the grace of Allah, we can tune our heart towards having the fullness of FET. You go back to my video on FET, F cycle, the feelings, emotion and thoughts intuitively coming from the realm of the glory of Allah into our realm, filling our jasad, our akal, our qalb and our ruh towards the glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowing the purpose and meaning of our existence, living a good, fulfilling life, achieving the best, fulfilling the best, and becoming an achiever in this life, always knowing that we have a wonderful mission and wonderful life in this earth if we only follow the Quran and the Sunnah, knowing that we are the Caliph of Allah, always striving to make ourselves good, helping others to be good, and making the world good, inshaAllah.